Hi, I'm Rachel. Welcome to my channel, La Brica Luz, where I share tips, techniques, and book recommendations from over 25 years working as a costume craftsperson.
As a theatrical milliner, I make hats of all styles from throughout history, across cultures, even fantastical creations that only existed in a costume designer's imagination.
And as an academic, I've done extensive research into historical methods and materials, as well as hat pattern making.
I've read dozens of millinery manuals in the process of choosing textbooks for my classes and studio reference library.
If you're a costumer, a cosplayer, a reenactor, or a home sewist with an interest in learning to recreate period hat styles, from bonnets to cloches and beyond, you'll want to check out my top three books for learning the skills of historical millinery. None of these books are step-by-step, project-based guides. You will not follow a series of directions and end up with a hat that looks just like the picture. If that's what you're seeking, it's best to buy a commercial pattern and work from that.
Vogue and McCall's have some lovely hat patterns of historical styles, as well as vendors on Etsy and other marketplaces.
These three books will teach you the craft of millinery in a broad sense, how to look at a hat design, determine what materials to use, and create your own pattern, construction strategy, and trimmings.
The first title is From the Neck Up, An Illustrated Guide to Hat Making by Denise Dreher, published in 1981.
If you only get one millinery book, this is the one I recommend. It's the required textbook for the graduate level course I teach in theatrical millinery at the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill. Dreher had an extensive career as a milliner for the stage.
For such legendary companies as the Guthrie Theatre of Minneapolis and the Stratford Festival in Ontario, Canada. It's a comprehensive text that covers all aspects of making hats for the stage. Materials, techniques, how to restore and alter extant hats, and more. There's an excellent glossary for terminology specific to the hat maker's craft, and an extensive section of grid scale patterns that spans a wide range of time periods and iconic shapes.
These can be used as the millinery equivalent to slopers. Make a pattern as a mock-up and then adjust the style lines to your desired shape. The book does presume that the reader has a familiarity with hand sewing and making garments from patterns.
If you just learned to thread a needle, this book might be too advanced for you.
You don't need experience with machine sewing, though. All the techniques are sewn by hand.
The second title is Edwardian Hats, The Art of Millinery by Anna Ben Youssef, published in 1909. This book has some great wisdom about pattern drafting and wire support foundations for those large-scale hats in style at the turn of the century,
which you can adapt to make hats with big brims of other eras as well.
Ben Youssef, who taught millinery at trade schools in Brooklyn in the early aughts, after a long career as a model milliner for middle-class clientele in Europe and the U.S., was among the first hat makers to write about the trade in instructional terms for a readership of novice and intermediate milliners with an interest in improving their skills. In addition to all the chapters on materials, techniques, and strategies for trimming hats, making fabric flowers, and manipulating feathers, this book has some fascinating advice on establishing and running a successful millinery business in 1909. Ben Youssef knew what she was talking about. Her own millinery business supported herself and four daughters after her husband abandoned the family, and paid passage for them all to emigrate to the U.S. from Britain.
The third title is Millinery for Every Woman by Georgina Kerr Kay, published in 1926.
This one was written in the middle of the drastic changes of the 1920s in fashionable hat styles and shapes. The materials and techniques may be familiar, especially if you've read other millinery manuals.
But the patterning advice will be helpful for achieving the sleek, close-fitting styles of the day. Over half of this book is about making ornamental flowers from fabric, ribbon, wire, and beads. And it's the go-to resource I consult when I need to make specific fabric flowers to adorn a hat, dress, or other costume piece. Here's a bonus recommendation. Classic Millinery Techniques by Anne Albrizio and Osnat Lustig, published in 1998. This book could be a good choice for those who want to follow step-by-step directions to make specific hat styles, although it largely contains contemporary designs rather than historical.
I refer to it frequently for the short section on feathers. It has great full-color photographs for visual identification of all types of feathers used in hat trimming.
And that concludes the best books, in my opinion, for learning historical and theatrical millinery. Making hats is an exciting, expressive art form, and a stylish hat often completes the look of a historical costume. If you decide to explore the craft of millinery further, please comment with your experience. I'd love to see photos of the hats you create. This video is part of the Costube Does BookTube Challenge.